It's time for Ryan's Roses, 102.7 Kiss FM. Dear Ryan, Sisney, and Tanya, this is from Gina and Chino Hills. So she says that she had her baby in the back seat. The seat back is, you know, backwards in the car. Her husband sits back there to keep the baby calm. The other day she was driving and her husband didn't realize that she could see what he was typing in the baby mirror.
Wow.
Gina, thanks for coming on for Ryan's Roses. What did you see in the baby mirror?
Yeah, well, I couldn't see the words or anything, but I definitely saw heart emojis and, like, photos going back and forth. So I said to my husband, who were you texting? And he was like, oh, what? No, just Mikey, which is this guy he works with. Honestly, I've been uneasy ever since.
What? How is your relationship with him? Like, how is your relationship now? Like, why does your brain go there? The cheating.
I mean, we're doing okay, but if I'm being honest, we haven't been, like, physical in a little while. I mean, we do have a 3-month-old.
That's what I was just going to say. You just had a baby.
You know, yeah. So, I don't know. It could just be, you know, like, hormones or something. But I just, you know, I do feel uneasy, and I want to follow it. I want to follow that gut, follow that lead.
Mm-hmm. All right. I think Sisney always asks the right question in that moment, which is if your head goes there, you've got, I mean, no matter what's happening, there's already an issue in your relationship. But let's get to how long you've been married here. How many years?
Yeah, we've been together 6 years.
Okay, hold on 1 second. It's Ryan's Roses. Ryan's Roses call. Gina's on the line. So she saw her husband typing some stuff she didn't think was the right in the baby mirror. So her husband's in the back seat. The baby's in the car seat. And there's a baby mirror, and
right.
She was reading texts that she thinks are to another woman that her husband was writing because she can see in that angle the baby mirror.
Because the baby mirrors have, like, a curve to them, and it
right.
really kind of, like, picks up a lot because you're trying to see the baby's face when they're driving backwards.
And did you tell us everything you saw in those text messages? Anything else?
That's all I saw.
Heart
emojis.
I thought
you could be texting someone. Mm-hmm. The heart emojis.
And then he's like, that's a buddy of mine? And
photos?
Sent out emojis too? What kind of photos?
Yes. I couldn't make it out.
Huh.
Okay, I'm just making my notes. Gina, I need you to say, Ryan, you have my permission to call, and then your husband's name. Go ahead.
Okay. Ryan, you have my permission to call my husband.
Be very quiet till we tell him he's on the air. Let's see who's top of mind when he thinks about red roses going to somebody. Good luck, Gina.
Okay.
Hi there, is this Sam?
Yeah, this is Sam.
Hi, my name is Bianca. I'm calling from the Secret Garden. How are you doing this morning?
All right, I guess.
Great. We actually deliver in Chino Hills and surrounding areas and offering a free promotion today. It's a dozen red roses that you can send to anybody that you'd like. They are free. I don't need cash or anything like that from you. We just ask that if you're pleased with our arrangements, you refer us to friends and family and come back as a customer one day. Are you there, Sam?
Oh, sorry. I was just processing all that. So, free roses to whoever I want?
That's correct. We can start with the name of the person. Sam?
So I just give you an address, and you'll send, like, a dozen free roses there today?
We can have them delivered today if that's convenient for you, or if you want to pick a different day, that works too. But like I said, we can start with the name and the note, and then on my next screen, we can get the information.
Okay, yeah, sure. Let's do it. Let's just, yeah.
Great. So who do you want to send them to?
You know what? Just put Lou, L-U. You know, not like Lou is in, like, you know, L-O-U, you know, just L-U.
Oh, is that short for something?
Yeah. I mean, but, yeah, it's just kind of like a nickname, you know?
Got it. Okay, what would you like to put on the card for Lou?
I hadn't really thought about that. I don't know. It's just kind of out of the blue here. Have it just something simple like XOXO, and then just throw my name on there.
Got it. Okay.
Sam, your voice is being broadcast on the radio. I have Gina, your wife on the line. Mom of a 3-month-old baby. Go ahead, Gina.
Hi. Who is Lou, Sam? Are you there? Who is Lou? I think I know who Lou is.
Who?
She's his boss. He works for a woman named Lupita, right? Am I right?
Yeah, so?
Okay, so why are you sending roses to your boss with XO on the card? Oh my God, are you sleeping with your boss?
Sam, you're
what?
On the air.
What?
You're on the air. Your wife saw you texting, apparently Lou. You just sent red roses to Lou XOXO Sam. Just tell her what's going on right now.
I'm not sleeping with her, okay? I'm not sleeping with my boss.
Well, of course you're not going to say that now.
Okay, so is Lou your boss, and is Lou the one that you sent the roses to because you're having an affair with her?
No. Okay, look, Gina, I would never cheat on you, okay? Just look.
Why are you sending another woman the flowers then?
Literally.
You know Edgar, right? The guy I work with?
Yeah.
Okay, well, Edgar, he got a different job, and he's going to be leaving at the end of the year.
I'm so confused.
Right?
Okay, fine.
Okay, so that dude makes twice what I make. Okay, like, I mean, he's leaving. There's going to be an opening, right? Look, I want that job, right? I want the job. I've been doing a little, I don't know. I mean, I guess flirting, you know? I've been throwing compliments, you know, chatting. I mean, it's working. She's starting to respond to it.
Look, Sam, this is taking entirely too long. Are you messing around with someone on the side here?
No, I'm flirting with my boss to get a promotion.
But that seems really wrong.
Yeah,
bro.
Very unethical.
It might be a little, but it's not like it's not as bad as what you thought I was doing.
So you're playing your boss, not your wife.
Right. I'm trying to get ahead in the world, you know?
This isn't the way.
All right, Gina, I don't know your husband. I don't believe him. I'm going to let you both go, and you can determine what you think is okay and what is not. And thank you very much for reaching out to Ryan's Roses. But this is Kiss. Let's come back. Roses. Got a feeling. Remember when I told you I ate too much turkey last week and my stomach didn't feel good?
Yeah.
That's the way Sam made me feel. 102.7 Kiss FM. Jingle Ball tickets coming in a few minutes. Guys, can we just grab you for a second? Ryan's Roses. I know you're a lot going on over there, but Ryan's Roses here.
I'm here.
Just to go back to it. So basically, Gina said she thinks her husband Sam is cheating on her. Now, the fact that she saw a text heart emoji on his phone go to someone else, she thinks another woman, obviously. Already there's trouble and distrust there. Well, we get him on the phone. He sends the roses to Lou, L-U-X-O-X-O, Sam. So he didn't send the roses to his wife, sent the roses to his boss. So then his wife says, you have an affair with your boss. He says, no, I'm just trying to get a promotion. He says, basically, I'm flirting with my boss to get a promotion. So I don't know. I don't believe him.
X-O-X-O is so inappropriate. How inappropriate has their relationship been, though?
You
That's
send
the
it
question.
All the time.
That's true. After I said it out of my mouth, I just realized I'm sure I've said that in many emails. Work emails?
Yes.
Okay, you don't know.
Yes, because you sent it to me in our group text.
Yeah, I feel like I probably have thrown on XOXO on work emails.
No, group text you do. Don't you guys do it all the time? I
can
probably go back and look.
Yeah, true. And I say, like, love you guys.
Well, that's... Yeah, exactly. Anyway, we digress. Yeah. I just think that the question is, do you believe that he's just flirting with his boss, trying to get a promotion, or do you think that, like, something else is going on?
Even if he is, And it's in his brain, all innocent, which it's not. He's still flirting with her. He's still like developing these feelings or pretending to have them, and then she might have right. them. And then, like, how far does that go before she acts on it and tries to make out with them or whatever the case may be? So it's just all bad.
Yeah, and she already feels insecure, and now he's flirting with the boss. This is it. It's going down the wrong path.
Isn't this
very
like
fast.
Illegal? Like, I don't know. Can't do that.
I'm scrolling through our group text to see, but there's a lot of stuff here. A lot of photos.
You can probably just search XOXO and everything that has XOXO will pop up.
I'm up to Happy New Year's, guys. Fun. Here we go. Happy New Year's, guys. No, so look. Love you so much.
See?
Okay. You were tipping some cups there. So love you so much.
So love you so much.
Happy New Year from Tokyo, Sydney.
Hey, that was a fun year.
Was that not last year?
No.
I went back 2 years. Oh, December 2022.
But look, go into your text messages, and in the search box, you can put XOXO, and it shows you every text message that has XOXO.
Oh, wait, that could be fun to see yeah. his text message. XOXO.
Let's come.
See, like, actually, mine is actually, Gabby.
Let me grab Maria. Maria, good morning. You heard this in Anaheim. Ryan's Roses, go ahead.
Oh, hi, Ryan.
Hi. So if your husband could double his salary with a little harmless flirting, you'd say go for it.
I would. I mean, I'm going to play a little bit devil's advocate here. Like, I don't see any problem with that. If it could just really change things, him hitting double salary. A little flirting could go a long way, and I'm not going to lie. I'm no angel. I've done it before when I was single. And it's about those connections that you make. And if you can strengthen that, as long as there's honesty in your relationship. I mean, Sam said he wasn't sleeping with her. And if Gina really knows Sam and how much, like, their relationship means to them and, like, their daughter and them being in a better place, I don't see the problem.
All right. Well, that's an interesting devil's advocacy point of view. Thank you very much for calling, Maria. She doesn't see the problem. She's done it before.
Yeah,
she's trying to get ahead.
Bring home the bacon, baby.
Oh, all right,
let's go.
Gosh.
$1,000 pay a bill next. Thanks for calling. We appreciate it. Thank you for listening to us every single Monday. When?
7:40.
Thursday, when?
7:40.
What?
Ryan's Roses.
That's it.